How was night school?
May I have your attention, children? I have two questions. Question number one. What cute, short, brilliant night school student just got an A+ in English history?
Wow.
Nell, that's sensational.
Well, you do know that English history is my best subject. It's just filled with love and romance. I know how every wife of Henry VIII was butchered.
Well, I love the first question. What's the second one?
Question number two. What cute, short, brilliant night school student will be taking night courses at the same college that Katie will be attending next year?
That's terrific.
Nell, that's great. Mm-hmm. Going from night school and then into college.
Oh, yes, honey. First, I'm going to get my B.A., then my M.A., and then an F.T.D.
But you mean Ph.D.?
Oh, no, honey, F.T.D. Because when I get my master's, I'm sending myself flowers. Oh, Nell. Not only are you brilliant, you are hilarious.
Hey, Nell, where do you see? Katie's upstairs dressing with her friend Rita. They're gonna show us some fashions they created.
Oh, wow. I can't wait to see Katie's face when she finds that we're gonna be co-eds. I wonder what I'm gonna look like in Bobby socks, huh? Oh, sweetheart, you know what?
What?
You're gonna be the cutest co-ed on campus next year.
Oh, no, we designed these clothes because we plan on selling them. We're opening a boutique.
Oh, honey, that's wonderful. Oh, Katie, I raised you to be sensible and thoughtful, and now you're gonna work part-time at a boutique while you go to college.
You don't understand, Nell. I'm not going to college.
I also raised her to have a sense of humor. You're not going to college?
Nope.
Come here, sweetheart. But get... Are you going?
Yes!
Where?
To college! I'm going!
Okay, you can live.
I believe you. Look, I'm not going to college.
Say what?
Look, just control yourself, all right? Nell, don't blame Katie for all this. Actually, the boutique was my idea.
Your idea? That does it! No more black friends for you girls. Now, look. I promised your mother on her deathbed you were going to college, and you are going to college.
Look, Nell, you can't make me feel guilty by bringing Mom into this.
What? Honey, I would never use your mother to make you feel guilty. Your poor father. All the sacrifices he made. Scripting and saving just have enough money to send you to college.
We got the ice cream!
Carl dropped the bundle at Baskin Robbins.
Hey, Chief, I can't believe you're going to eat all three scoops.
Joey, the vanilla and the chocolate are just to coat the throat. Rocky Road is where the gusto is. Never forget that, Joey.
Oh, right.
Who's for ice cream?
Rita, Katie, stay. Chief, I want to talk to you.
What is it?
Well, I'm not going to try to spare you the pain. I'm going to give it to you straight. Katie says she's not going to college. She's going to open a boutique.
Is there any club soda?
Did you hear what I just said? I said Katie's not going to college.
So? I never went to college. And I turned out all right.
Says who? Baskin and Robbins?
I have confidence in Katie. She wants to try her hand at running a business. I don't think she should go to college.
You see there, honey? Your daddy doesn't even think you're good enough to go to college. But that's all right. We'll show him, won't we, baby?
Dad, do you know the money you put away for me for college?
Mm-hmm.
Can I use it for my boutique?
Sure. But you can't start a business on $3,000.
Well, see, we've already applied for a minority loan, and we stand a good chance because I'm black.
You racist.
Well, we're getting help from my father's accountant, and he's Jewish.
Jewish? God, Jewish people don't know anything about accounting.
Look, Nell, Rita and I know what we're doing.
And you don't know anything about running a business.
I know fashion.
Fashion? Do you think fashion is the most important thing in running a boutique?
No.
The most important thing is having a good stereo.
All right, what about location?
Well, I figured right behind the cash register.
And she's not even blonde.
Leave it alone now. The girls know what they're doing.
Well, you don't know what you're doing.
Well, at least our fathers are on our side.
Great.
Okay. You don't have to take my word for it. But why don't we ask Grandpapa for the wisdom of his years? Grandpapa, your granddaughter Kathleen has decided she's not going to college. She's going to open a boutique. Now, what do you think about that, honey?
I think she should be very good at that.
Butt out, Grandpapa.
Look, Nell, even if I wanted to go to college, I couldn't. My grades are too low.
Yeah, not everybody should go to college.
In Katie's case, not everybody should go to high school.
Thanks, guys.
See?
Look, honey, low grades don't necessarily have to keep you out of college. Now, if I can get you in spite of your grades, would you at least consider it?
Look, I can't promise anything now.
Good, I'll get you in. You see, my dearest and closest friend, Addie Wilson, just so happens to have power of connections in the educational department.
Nell, just because Addie works for the university system doesn't mean you can ask your best friend to do something that's highly irregular, unscrupulous, and unethical.
Oh, please. What are friends for?
Nell.
Honey, I have to talk to you.
I'm sorry. I'm a little busy right now.
It's an emergency.
What?
It's something awful with Katie.
What happened? Come in here.
Honey, Katie's not going to college.
That's the emergency?
No, no. It gets worse. She wants to open a boutique. You got a man here?
Nell, honey, we'll discuss college in the morning,
No,
okay?
This can't wait till the morning. I'm Nell Hopper, Addie's dearest and closest friend.
Dr. Fred Robinson.
A doctor?
I'm a dentist.
Wasn't your ex-husband a dentist?
Nell, I think I hear the elevator.
No, no, honey, I can walk down late. I have a problem here.
Okay, okay, Nell. What do you want from me?
I want Katie into college and not a boutique.
Nell, our university studies tell us if a student doesn't want to be in college, that student does not do well.
But I want her with the other gifted students.
What kind of grades does she get?
That's not important.
Go home, Nell.
No, actually, she has a wonderful mind. It's hardly ever been used.
Oh, Nell.
Oh, come on, can't you use her influence to get her into school?
How can you ask me to use my influence to get a girl into college who has poor grades?
Well, any jerk can get a girl in the school who has good grades.
What you're asking me to do is highly unethical.
Oh, come on. I thought you were my best friend.
I never asked you to do anything against your principles.
Whoa. When you first came into town, you begged me to fix you up with a man, and I want you to know it is totally against my principle to fix a woman up with a man.
Girl, you got a mouthful of teeth, and you're lying through every one of them.
I suppose I'm lying when I say I taught you how to get a man. How do you think you got that bozo here?
You leave that bozo out of this.
And I thought you would help me.
Oh, I'm gonna help you, honey. I'm gonna help you out the door.
You know what? You're one cold woman, Addie Wilson. No wonder your husband fell asleep while you were lovemaking. Oh! Does this mean you are not going to help me?
You know, if I had known that my decision not to go to college would break up Nell and Addie's friendship, I might have gone.
Gone where?
To college.
You don't have the grades.
Maybe not, but I'm still in the top third of my senior class.
Out of 400 kids, you're 395th. That's the bottom third.
Well, I date guys in the top third. You know, there must be some way to get Nell and Addie back together again.
It's all taken care of.
What do you mean? They haven't been speaking for 3 days.
I know that. Look, I told Addie that Nell wants to apologize. Now I'm going to tell Nell that Addie's coming over here to apologize.
What?
Look, once they're together, they'll work everything out. It's called interpersonal group dynamics.
Let's go, Katie.
Yeah. We don't want to be here when the interpersonal dynamics hit the fan. Where's Nell?
She's in the laundry room, fluffing and folding.
What's the occasion?
Me, Chief, and Grandpa are gonna watch the Lupus Murphy boxing match on TV.
Joey's first fight. We're gonna show the lad two pugilists demonstrating their scientific skills in the masterful art of boxing. I still say Lopez will beat his brains out. Pop salt is no good for you.
What do you know? You're picking Lopez.
Nell, Addie's coming over to see you.
Oh, that's good, honey. I won't be here.
Nell, she's coming over to see you.
I don't want to talk to her.
Nell, that's probably her right now.
I don't want to talk to her.
Nell, she's coming over to apologize. It's not easy for a woman like Addie to swallow her pride. I mean, the two of you were kids together in Alabama. She's crawling over here on her hands and knees begging you not to break up a lifelong friendship with a woman she loves.
All right. I'll make her eat dirt.
I think I'll go hide with my sisters.
What's the rush, Pop? The fight's not on yet.
This fight's gonna be better than the one on TV. Joey, there is no better fight in the world than two adult women going at it. Round one coming up.
Well, what?
I said, well, first.
And I said, well, what first?
They're still feeling each other out. Addie floats like a butterfly.
All right. If you came on to apologize, you better get on with it.
Apologize? Julie said you wanted to apologize to me.
Oh, she did? Well, I'll just have to take care of her later.
Well, you can apologize to me now.
For what?
For barging into my apartment and ruining my evening.
God, don't you blame your lousy love life on me.
Low blow.
Your behavior was crude, embarrassing, and frankly inexcusable.
Left herself wide open.
I was crude and embarrassing? You slammed the door in my face twice.
Somebody give me a door.
Too bad our boys overseas are not getting this.
Well, it's obvious there's no talking to you.
Get your face out of my face.
You get your face out of my life.
You get your face out of my house.
I'm taking my face home. I'm getting out of my house.
Addie, sweetheart, please come back here.
Yes, Nell.
One more thing.
If Lopez hits like Nell, he'll murder him.
Any sign of Juliet?
That is the third time in 5 minutes you've asked me that. Now stop bugging me. I'm enjoying the obituaries.
Just let me know when she gets there. That little liar's gonna have a nose as big as Pinocchio's when I get through with her.
Psst. Grandpa, is Nell here?
She's in there, Pinocchio.
Oh, well, I just remembered I'm sleeping over at my friend's house for the rest of the year.
Any sign? Oh, Julie.
Nell! Is that you?
Yes, Fresh. Can we have a little chat in the kitchen?
A chat?
Uh-huh.
In the kitchen?
Yes.
Alone?
Uh-huh.
I'd rather stay where there's a witness.
Get over here, girl.
This one won't go one round.
I'm sorry.
Who gave you the right to interfere in my life?
No, I was just trying to save a beautiful friendship. It worked so well in that short
story. You button your lip, girl. Don't you ever stick your nose in my business again.
That's telling her, Nell.
Why are you on her side? I'm your granddaughter.
You know something I admire about Nell? She never sticks her nose into other people's business.
That's telling her, Grandpapa.
Unless it has to do with going to college or opening a boutique.
Butt out, Grandpapa.
Fair's fair, Nell. You interfered in Katie's life, Julie interfered in your life.
That's telling her, Grandpa.
Oh, come on, don't you understand? I promised your mother. Isn't it every parent's dream that their kid go to college?
My parents had a dream. You know, I come from a long line of Polish sausage stuffers. And when I came of age in Poland, my father assumed that I would carry on the family tradition and stuff sausages. He was shocked when I told him I was going to America. I said, I love you, Papa, but you can stuff it. See, sometimes a child knows what it has to do and does it.
I think I get the point, Grandpa.
Yeah, there are no guarantees in life, Nell. You make your choice and hope it turns out all right. Of course, I've made some mistakes in life. Here's one of them now.
Nell, I can't find anything to eat.
I'll fix you something in a minute, Chief. But first, I want to give a very wise and beautiful man a big kiss.
Mm. Well, don't get too lovey-dovey. It'll kill my appetite.
Grandpa, I didn't know your father was a sausage stuffer.
He wasn't. He was a blacksmith. Wouldn't let me in the business either. He said none of his sons was big and brawny enough to be a blacksmith. So he turned the whole thing over to my sister.
You're pretty smart there, Grandpa.
Yeah, I'm smart enough to get in the kitchen before your father eats the paper off the wall.
Oh, just the person I want to see.
Yeah, Nell.
Listen, sweetheart.
Nell.
What?
I've been doing some thinking.
Oh, honey, that's terrific. You know, you should try to do a little of that every day.
Oh. Well, I decided to go to college.
What?
Look, if you think it was that important to Mom and it's that important to you, then I'll go. Hey, look, I made it through high school. I can make it through college, right? All I need to do is start dating another sexy honor student.
I don't want you to go to college. I want you to, you know, to open your boutique.
What?
I was wrong, and I'm sorry. Look, I want you to follow your own dream, stuff your own sausage.
What?
Well, see, when Grandpapa was young, never mind. You just open your shop, but you make sure I get 20% discount, okay?
Oh, thanks, Nell. I'll make my mother proud.
I know you will.
And my mama, too.
Oh, shoot. But I'm in trouble. I gotta go over to Addie's and apologize. And I know that cow is gonna make me eat dirt.
There you go.
Thanks, honey. You do know that I love you, right?
Yeah, and I love you, too. But I'm afraid I can't give you any discount in my boutique.
Why?
Business is business.
Well, as your wise old grandfather says, stuff it.
Mean an emergency.
Something happened to Grandpa.
What? Come in here.
Well, I didn't think he would fall for that a second time. No, wait. Okay, wait. I want to apologize for jeopardizing a lifelong friendship. I asked you to get Kate into college. I'm very sorry I was wrong. Please accept my apology.
I accept. Get out.
Oh, darling, artificially sweetened cappuccino.
Hello. Let me guess. You're a dentist.
Yes, Dr. Jamal Anderson.
Nell, I think I hear the elevator, and you don't want to miss it because it's the express flight.
Wait a minute. You act like you're still mad.
Mad? Try furious.
Okay, okay. I want to apologize for barging here the other night when you had that other dentist here. Well, what do you expect? Every time I come here, there's a man here.
Just how many men do you have?
But wait a minute, Buster. I don't think that's any of your business.
Oh, hold on. Now, you stay out
of this. Wait a minute, girl. I'm trying to help you.
You told me I was the only man in your life.
You bought that?
What about it, Addie?
Don't push it, Jamal. You know, when I made this date with you, I was still on Novocaine.
But when it wears off, it's gonna hurt like hell.
You know, you are single-handedly wrecking my entire love life.
What? The only hot thing you got perking around here is that cappuccino, and I'm gonna have some.
You know, you're right. Never trust a man who admires your gums.
Oh, well.
Oh, gosh.
Another evening shot.
Thanks.
What should we do?
I got a great idea. Why don't we go to the movies and pig out on popcorn and Cracker Jacks?
Oh, and that stuff is terrible on your teeth.
I know. Probably have to see another dentist in the morning.
I've been thinking of having a checkup myself.
Well, let's see.
The American Dental Association? Girls, I can't tell you what joy brings to my heart to write this check out for your new boutique.
Oh, thanks, Nell. This'll just cover the loan deposit on this terrific store we found.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's wonderful, honey.
And do you know it'll be available in the fall, and it's right across the street from the college.
Right across from the college? Hey, uh-huh. That's a good idea. You know what? Listen, while you
go to school,
Just hear me out. Wait, you can watch the shop while she goes to school on Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays. Then you can watch the shop while she goes to school on Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays. You don't have to go. Okay, hey. You know there's night school?
No.
You can close the shop at 6 o'clock, then we can all go to school again.
No college at day, no college at night, no college period.
Hey,
right, Rita?
Hey.
Right.
Hey, I know what I'm licked. I know what I'm licked. Here. Here's your check. Good luck.
Thank you.
Okay. Here we go.
Nell, you didn't sign the check.
Oh, how stupid of me. You mean you can't cash that check if I don't sign it, right?
No, we can't. No.
Okay. How about a correspondence course?
No. Oh, no. Please, come on. No. Hey, no, please.